Hi, I'm Leah, and I'm a speech-language pathologist. I'm here today to talk to you about how to make a visual aid using the LAMP Words for Life icons. Now, if you are looking for a step-by-step tutorial on how to do this, that's going to be the second part of this video. The first part, I just want to explain what this is, why I would use it, and how I use it. So, as I said, the visual aid. Whenever someone has a hard time using their words, sometimes it can also be hard to understand words. That's not always the case, but sometimes it is. And for those people, if I can make the learning visual, it can really help. So for my kids like that I work with, I want to make it as easy as possible for them to use symbolic language. I'm going to use a visual aid. For this specific one, I've got the word eat, and I've also got the words apple, banana, and pretzel. For each one, it shows exactly what that child needs to press in order to get to that final word for each of these. I have this set up for a two-word combo. It doesn't have to be, though. I could just have one word, or I could just have the words that are options for what they like to eat. In this example, I'm going to be using two words. Now, there are lots of ways I could use this. I could do this for someone who finds it really important to pick out what clothes they wear that day. I could have colors over here, or I could have clothing items over here. So you can say, I want a yellow shirt, or I want black pants. You can also use this in book activities. If there is a keyword that you're really trying to teach that's important for everyday life, that's really good at getting someone what they need and want, maybe I'm reading a book that has the word stop in it a lot, I can just make the little icon for stop, and I can put that in the book where that word happens, so I can show them how to say stop. You can use it for almost anything, really. So let's talk about how I would use this one. For this one, it's going to be for requesting a snack. I'm going to be thinking about where that child would naturally make that kind of statement or request. And then I'm going to put this wherever that happens. So for a child who would normally grab your hand and take you to the refrigerator or open up the pantry and start making sounds to get your attention, that's where I'm going to put this. I'm going to tape this to the front of the refrigerator, or I'm going to put it on the inside of that pantry, taped right to the shelf where those snacks are. That way, this is exactly where it needs to be when they need it. Now, when you first start using it, though, they aren't going to understand what it is. Probably. Some kids are just geniuses. So I'm going to model how to use it. I'm going to be listening for those natural requests, and then I'm going to bring the words over and show them how I use it. I'm going to figure out what they want. So let's say this kid's wanting pretzels. They're pointing to them. I'm going to say, oh, you want to eat pretzels? Apple, eat. Apple, eat. Pretzels. Apple, snacks, pretzel. Apple, snacks, pretzel.
Pretzel. Eat pretzel.
You want to eat pretzels? Cool. Let's get them. I'm going to immediately grab those pretzels, and I'm going to give them to them. Now, model, model, model. That child is going to be listening and learning every time you show this to them and show them how it works. You don't have to force them to push the apple icon and push eat and then push apple, snack, pretzel in order for them to learn how to say this. They can learn just by watching you. It's totally okay once you're pretty sure they understand the concept of this to invite them to say it. You can say, what is it you want? And wait. Maybe you can even pull up that last page if you're pretty sure they want pretzels and wait. But if they don't want to use it, don't make them. Their communication should never feel like work. Plus, if you can understand what they want and they can get that across to you just by pointing it at a bag of pretzels, that's acceptable. They are probably going to want to use the word pretzel on their device with someone who's not familiar with them and doesn't get the message, though. Cool. So now that we know what this is and how and why we would use it, let's talk about how I made it. So let's look at the step-by-steps. Let's look.
Welcome to my desktop. So, in order to start making visual aids, you're going to need this software right here, New Voice. But when you go to look for it, it's going to be called the PASS software. So go to your search engine and type in PRC, PASS software. It should be the first option that pops up. If not, it should be pretty close to the top. I'm going to click the link, and it'll take us to PRC's website. Scrolling down, you'll see a link, download the free PASS software. That'll take us to where we can download it. You'll also see a bunch of other information on this page that can help you learn how you can use this and other ways you can use it. I'm going to go ahead and click the link, and here you will see the actual download link here. Agree to the license agreement, and then you can download it. You can also download the quick reference guide if you wish. Once you've downloaded it, you can go ahead and open it up and get started. Okay, I'm going to accept the agreement, and then I'm going to choose the vocabulary that I want to use. Now, I use LAMP Words for Life with almost all of the kids I work with, but Unity is really good for eye gaze users, and if you have someone that's going to be scanning, Core Scanner is pretty awesome too. I'm going to be choosing LAMP. And then I'm going to be picking the standard view, just because that's what most of the kids that I work with use. They do have a visual impairment version if you need high contrast symbols. So I'm going to click standard. I'm going to go to the full vocabulary because that will give me all of the words and all of the icons. I'm going to hit OK to save it as this name. And now I have access to it. If you ever need to find one of the other vocabularies, you can do so with the gear, the toolbox, user area menu, switch user area menu, and you can see some of the other ones here, or you can go back into replace user area, and you can replace one of these, like maybe the Unity 61 hit, with the predefined vocabulary, English, and then here all the other vocabularies here. So maybe if I were making one for someone who needed the visual impairment one, I could access it here. Okay, so let's start making that visual aid. I'm going to go into Word just because I find it really easy to work within, and I'm going to insert a table so that my spacing's nice and even. I'm using two words, and my second column has three words in it, so I'm making a 2x3 table. Now I'm going to plop my icons in here. In order to get a copy of these icons, I'm going to be using this snipping tool program here. It comes with Microsoft. So if you have a PC, you probably already have access to it. If not, you can find it in the App Store. I'm going to open up the snipping tool. And I'm going to hit New. The first icon that I need is this eat icon. So I'm going to click, drag, and let go, and it gets the icon for me. I'm going to hit the copy button, and then I'm going to go to my Word document, and I'm going to paste it right there. I'm also going to resize it. That way, all of my icons I do can fit into one line. I don't want them to go underneath each other. I want them to be in one line next to each other. The next icon I need is the eat icon. So I'm going to click the apple and grab this one with my snipping tool. New, click and drag, copy. Go into my Word document, and I will paste it right next to that one. Resize it so it matches. Awesome. Now I need my other words over here. For Apple, the first icon is the exact same as this one. So I'm going to copy this one and put it in this line. Now I need to grab the fruit icon because it's the next hit. snipping tool, new, click and drag. Ah, you can see my little mouse highlight there. Copy, go to Word, and paste. Resize. I'll just keep doing this for all of the words. And there we have our visual aid. Now, personally, I don't like seeing these lines left, so I'm going to click on my table and get rid of the borders. I also like to have something in the middle to show that I am combining words. I personally go to Insert and Icons and search for plus in order to put that plus sign in there. Select it, Insert, and there it is. Now, to drag it over there, I'm gonna have to change where it is in the layers. So I'm gonna click this symbol and tell it to go in front of the text. That'll let me drag it wherever I want. There you have it. Now, there is one other way that you can get this that's a little bit faster. You just also won't have the words on here. Show you how to do it real quick. If you go into the program and go to this icon here, the spell num, click it and look up at the top, you'll see the purple word finder tool. Click it. So if I type in one of those words like banana, oops, banana, and hit okay, it'll show me the pathing for that icon. Apple, fruits, banana. You could just take that whole line and use it. I personally don't because I do like to see it exactly as it appears on the program, but you can do it that way if you want.
Thank you so much for joining me. I hope that you found that information helpful. If there are any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. I'll do my best to answer them. If you want to hear more from me, if there's something else that you would like some kind of tutorial on that PRC doesn't already have up as something that's accessible on all of their resources, link below if you need that. Just let me know and I can do my best to make a video for that as well. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye.